buzz, incredibly damning report by Louis Free. This line stood out for me. Our most saddening and sobering finding is the total disregard for the safety and welfare of Sandusky's child victims by the most senior leaders at Penn State. It doesn't get worse than that, does it?
No, it can't get any worse, except when I think it can't get any worse, it does get worse. I mean, a complete blanket condemnation of Penn State's conduct based not on anonymous sources, based on evidence, based on emails. What is so hideous, and this report reinforces it, they did bend over backwards, Mr. Paterno and Mr. Spanier and Mr. Schultz and Mr. Curley. They bent over backwards not only to cover up the sexual abuse of Jerry Sandusky, but to take care of Jerry Sandusky, to make sure he was insured for in retirement, to give him a pension payment unprecedented in Penn State history, to give him keys to all the buildings, to give him his own office. They didn't give a damn ever about any of those kids.
And in relation to Joe Paterno, Buzz, I mean, I have always been disquieted by the kind of hero worship he's been attracting since this case first came to the public attention. Clearly, he's now dead and he can't say anything about this report. But it is so damning about Joe Paterno. I just think you cannot call him a legend anymore. This is a man that harbored serious child abuse. He allowed a load more kids to get abused, didn't he?
Well, there's no question. I mean, as the report says, once again, through documentation, through emails, he did know about the first alleged incident of sexual abuse involving Jerry Sandusky in 1998. He lied about that. He knew much more about the 2001 incident in terms of trying to cover it up in 2001 than he ever said. He lied about that. The man is not a legend. I'm sorry he's dead. In my mind, not only does he have no legacy left, he was a bad.